行啊，好。弟兄姐妹，我们大家预备一颗清洁的心，来继续聚会敬拜真神。
Francis says, prepare a pure heart to continue our worship of our true God.
同心默祷。
Pray in silence.
阿门。奉主耶稣圣名开始我们的联合聚会。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we begin our combined service.
我们唱赞美诗249首。
We sing hymn 249.
灵洗革个人。哦，249首灵洗个人。
249, they were in a upper chamber.
来，一二三。从前门徒同心合一，在无损街求灵犀。耶稣允许果然施政，圣灵降临来印证。主，我今是大全能。主啊，今是大全能，主啊，今是大全能，永生灵洗个人，无论降生之天降下，仿佛大风吹雾内，四色火焰落人头上。感动个人所方圆，主啊，今是大全能，主啊，今是大全能，主啊，今是大全能，永生灵犀个人。门徒都被圣灵充满，为正道竭力争辩，与秉公贵大显全能，引人归主乐无边。主啊，今是大全能。主啊，今是大全能。主啊，今是大全能。永生灵犀个人。主继续祝福带领我们安息日的机会。
Let us pray to ask the Lord Jesus for his blessings in our Sabbath service.
特别我们这两次都是谈圣灵跟邪灵的事情。
Most especially in these few sessions, we are talking about the matters regarding the Holy Spirit and the evil spirit.
更需要圣灵的带领跟来指引、来辨明。
All the more we need guidance from the Holy Spirit to guide and discern.
我们奉主的名同心祷告。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray in one accord.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚 Hallelujah, 哈利路亚，感谢主耶稣。哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
主所亲爱的大家安息日平安，安息日蒙福。
The beloved ones of the Lord Jesus, peace be with you on the Sabbath day.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
By the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来见证这个使徒行传第二章的危机。
We continue to witness the crisis of the church in Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2.
我们从第一章看到六种危机。
From chapter 1, we have seen six kinds of crisis.
那 到第二章的时候呢，我们看到 第二章的第一个危机就是毁谤的危机。
And the first crisis we saw from chapter 1 was a crisis of blasphemy.
那就是在二章的第十三节。
That's recorded in chapter 2 verse 13.
那么圣灵一降临的时候就已经被毁谤了。
Upon the downpour of the Holy Spirit, it was already been blasphemed.
并不是说现在的圣灵 才被人家毁谤。
It was not that this is only blasphemed today.
而且圣灵一降临，在那个时刻正在讲座灵园祷告的时候就被毁谤。两种不同的人在听到。两种不同的心态在听到。
During the listening to a sermon, there's always two kinds of people or two kinds of attitudes listening to a sermon.
那么如果顺从神的呢，谦卑顺服的呢，他一定会，圣灵会带领他。
The obedient to the word of God would be humble enough to allow the Spirit of God to guide them.
如果心里存着骄傲呢，不圣洁的呢，那魔鬼会利用他。
And those who are arrogant and are not clean in their hearts will be used by the devil.
那么就是毁谤啊。
To blaspheme.
那主耶稣从圣经上我们也看到圣灵被毁谤最少有四个原因。
From Acts of the Apostles, we can see that the Holy Spirit was blasphemed for four reasons.
就是主耶稣说，因为世人不能够接受这个圣灵。
The first reason being, as spoken by the Lord Jesus, because the world cannot receive the Holy Spirit.
请注意哦，他不是不明白哦，他是不能够接受哦。
Take note that it is not that the world cannot understand, but the world cannot
receive. 所以有些你跟他解释了，甚至看到神迹了，看到圣灵体验了，他还是不信的哟。
Some people have already tried to understand it and experience it and seen the miracles of the Holy Spirit, and yet they still cannot accept it.
这个就是应验主耶稣讲的，他们不接受。
This is to fulfill the words of the Lord Jesus that they cannot receive the Holy Spirit.
那当然就会进入到毁谤里面去了。
And therefore they will end up blaspheming the Holy Spirit.
那第二个就是保罗的解释。
Second, from the explanation of Paul,
保罗说属血气的人不能够领会圣灵的事情。
The natural man, those who are carnally minded, cannot receive the matters of the Holy Spirit.
因为他充满着血气啊，属世的思想，属世的行为。
Because they are full of the thoughts and the minds of the carnal.
那么第三个原因。
The third reason.
因为保罗说他们不能够借出，没有借出圣灵的果子，他们只是在讲灵言。
Because Paul said that they did not bear the fruits of the Holy Spirit, they only remained at speaking in tongues.
甚至有一些行为比外邦人更糟糕。
And their conduct and behavior may be maybe even worse off than the Gentiles.
所以他在讲灵言的时候，变成好像成了锣响的啪一般，锣啊啪啊，那是一种很吵的，感觉到很刺耳的声音啊。
And as they receive the Holy Spirit, and they become the sounding gong or the cymbal that makes a lot of noise and a lot of disturbing noises.
啊，如果这些糟糕的信徒又在讲灵言，确实你听起来呢，你有一种很难接受的感觉。
And if you see these members who have already received the Holy Spirit sounding like that, you cannot find it acceptable.
有一个信徒呢，有一些信徒呢，他在祷告的时候声音很大声。
There are some members who pray very loudly.
几乎都是用喊的，喊出来的声音呢。
Some of them almost had to scream during prayers.
几乎所有人的祷告的时候都被他盖住了，都听到他一个人的那个喊叫的声音。
And the sound of this person's scream is even louder than all the sounds of prayer from other people.
对，引起很多信徒的一种很厌烦的感觉，不会感谢神的那种感觉。
And this definitely provoked some members to feel frustrated or to feel unpleased by this prayer.
这个信徒呢，他有时星期六，有时星期五，就在教会门口来做生意啊，摆摊做生意，在教会的大门口，正正的大门口摆摊做生意啊。
And this particular member, sometimes on a Friday or a Saturday Sabbath service, in front of at the entrance of the church, he or she set up a stall to do business.
然后平时很少很少来聚会。
And he or she rarely came to church.
可是他偶尔来聚会呢，就大大声祷告，他有圣灵的，也是在讲灵言的，所谓的灵言呢。
But at these few occasions when he came to the church to pray, he prayed aloud in tongues.
我们也没有怀疑他的圣灵嘛。
We did not suspect the Holy Spirit that he had.
这种祷告，这种声音，这种祷告圣灵的声音，让人家感受到很厌烦，不会赞美神，不会从心里感谢神，不会。
But the sound of his prayer from his Holy Spirit, we can hear that this is kind of disturbing, and we don't hear the kind of praises to God that in his prayer.
就是像保罗说的哦，哥林多前书十三章一节里面说，成了名的锣哐砰这样吵死，一种很嘈杂的声音而已，没有其他的内容。
It is just as spoken by Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 that this kind of sounds became a sounding board, a loud cymbal, which has no content.
我的意思是，圣灵被毁谤，这是其中一个原因，也是有它的道理啊。
I mean to say that for the Holy Spirit to be blasphemed by some people, there are some reasons behind it.
那第四个原因是最重要的。
The fourth reason is the most important.
还记得吗？第四种，为什么圣灵会被毁谤，还记得吗？
Do you remember what is the fourth reason that the Holy Spirit is being blasphemed?
就是在祷告的时候有邪灵欺骗，有邪灵的欺骗。
Is that there is a deception of the devil, the evil spirit during our prayer.
那邪灵怎么样欺骗呢？
How does the evil spirit deceive?
邪灵就模仿圣灵的声音，圣灵的祷告。
The evil spirits emulates or imitates the sound of the Holy Spirit.
对，传道就见证了很多有关于邪灵的声音嘛，是吗？
The preacher has already testified about the sounds of the evil spirit.
有一些声音像狗叫的声音。
Some of which sounded like a dog barking.
有一些像蛇的声音，蛇吐舌头的声音。
Some sounded like the snake sneezing.
有一些像野兽吼叫的声音。
Some are likened to a wild beast roaring.
还有很多这种邪灵的声音啊，我们没有时间再讲下去了。
There are a lot of different sounds of the evil spirit that we cannot take too much time to talk on. These are not the sounds of the Holy Spirit. By the help of the Holy Spirit, today we will study, we will witness the sound of the Holy Spirit, which are very different.
从圣经启示我们，跟我们的祷告情形告诉我们，根本不是让人害怕的，根本圣灵的声音是不让人那种害怕的。
From the revelation of the Bible and also our personal experience during prayers, this should not be something that is fearful to people.
圣灵的声音是怎么样的呢？
So how is the sound of the Holy Spirit like?
耶稣怎么样启示我们，怎样让我们知道？
How did the Lord Jesus reveal and let us know?
请看启示录的第十四章。
Return to Revelation chapter 14.
启示录十四章，我们读一节到二节。
Revelation chapter 14, verse 1 to 2.
来，我们一起读圣经，来一二三。
Really、
我又观看，见羊羔羊站在锡安山，同他又有144,000人，都有他的名和他父的名写在额上。第二节，我听见从天上有声音，像众水的声音和大雷的声音。并且我所听见的好像弹琴的所弹的琴声。这里我们看到什么呢？
What do you see here?
我们在这里看到主耶稣在锡安，站在锡安山。
From here we can see that the Holy Spirit was standing, the Lord Jesus was standing on Mount Zion.
主耶稣在哪里？
Where was the Lord Jesus?
主耶稣就在教会里。
The Lord Jesus is in the church.
主耶稣与教会同在。
The Lord Jesus abides with the church.
这里说羔羊站在锡安山，主耶稣就在教会里面。
It is stated that a lamb standing on Mount Zion, meaning the Lord Jesus is in the church.
那还有十四万四千人也在锡安山，也在里面。
Together with 44,000 people on Mount Zion.
这些都是圣洁的得救的这个圣徒啊。
These are all the holy saints who are to be saved.
里面有很多关于他们的见证，他们这十四万四千的信仰的见证在他们身上。
There are many testimonies of faith of these 44,000 saints.
这时候呢，他就听见约翰就听见从天上有声音。
At this time, John heard a voice from heaven.
其实这个就是我们祷告的声音来的。
That is the voice of our prayer.
十四万四千人在祷告，在唱诗的声音啊，也有祷告，也有唱诗。
The voice of prayer and singing of hymns by 44,000 saints.
因为听到祷告声音过后，第三节就看到十四万四千人在那边唱诗了，有没有？
Because as you can read on from verse 3, after hearing this voice, they are able to see this 44,000 people singing hymns.
这些祷告的声音像什么呢？
So how does this voice of prayer sound like?
一像众水的声音，祷告灵人的声音，好像众水的声音。
It sounded like the voice of many waters, the sound of the speaking in tongues, sound like that.
灵人的声音又好像大雷的声音。
Secondly, the sound of loud thunder.
第三，圣灵的声音又好像弹琴所弹的琴声，好像琴的声音，弹琴的声音。
Thirdly, the sound of the Holy Spirit is also the sound of the harpists playing their harps.
这是主耶稣给我们的启示，让我们所明白的是圣灵的声音是怎么样。
This is the revelation by the Lord Jesus to help us understand how the sound of the Holy Spirit sounds like.
那我现在来做见证，在我们真耶稣教会里面的祷告的见证。
Allow me to testify to you the testimony of a prayer in True Jesus Church.
我们祷告的灵源的声音好像众水的声音，真的是这样。
The prayer of our church truly sounds like the sounds of many waters.
众水有海水的声音。
The many waters also refer to the sound of the ocean, the sea.
也有河水的声音，河流的声音。
It also sounds like a streams of river.
也有瀑布的声音。
It also sounds like waterfall.
也有小溪流、小溪的声音。
It also sounds like small rivers and streams.
又有好像大雨下大雨的声音。
It could also sound like the downpour of rain.
又像下小雨的声音。
Sometimes a pour of drizzle.
这一切就是众水，各种不同的水的声音啊。
These are all sounds of different kinds of waters.
我现在要见证就是海浪的声音，祷告好像海水的声音，海浪的声音。
I would like to testify now the sound of the prayer likened to the sounds of waves.
我们每一年哦，年尾都是有举办这个神短期神学训练班，十二月份。
At end of every year, we always conduct this short-term theological course in October.
那一年的学生呢，感觉比较调皮，感觉比较不听话，甚至比较让人家做一些让我们传道人很伤心的一些行为。
And at this particular batch of the theological course, the students happen to be the naughtier bunch who always do things that would hurt the feelings of the preachers.
那一次负责这个训导的，就是纪律的那个传道哦，一直在骂，几乎每天都在骂，然后骂到他自己在哭，哭着在骂，骂了又哭，都不听话。
So much so that the preacher who was in charge of the disciplinary role had to scold them every day, day after day, so much so that he was crying from scolding them.
那么，那在祷告的时候，这个传道呢，他就不要再骂了，也不用再讲了，就叫大家一起祷告吧，一起祷告，不用再讲什么了。
And until the point where he finally gave up and he said, there's no need to scold anymore, we will do a prayer together.
哦，在祷告的时候，大家都被圣灵充满。
During that prayer, everyone was filled with the Holy Spirit.
结果连外邦人啊，各地邻舍的啊，很多人跑来教会来看啊，来听啊，到底发生什么事？
And it was so strange that the neighbors surrounding the church were coming into the church to hear to find out what was happening.
我又邻舍跑过来教会看，来问你们教会发生什么事情啊？
These Gentile neighbors came to the church and to ask what is happening here.
我们说没有啊，我们都在祷告啊，那时也正在祷告，他们也看我们祷告啊，就是在祷告，没有发生事情啊。
At the time, we were all just praying, and there was nothing happening, and they were also witnessing our prayer at that moment.
哦，不是的，我听到你们教会有海浪的声音啊，海浪的海水一波一波的声音啊。
And they said to us that no, we heard sounds of waves and waves of the ocean in your church.
而且不是一两个人听到哦。左右邻舍那些住在那个 Fed 楼的那些公寓的很多人在窗口一直看着我们的教会，因为他们听到这个声音是从教会发出来的。
And it is not just a few people who witnessed this or who heard this, but the neighbors from the flats next door, they also heard this from their windows as well.
这些左右邻舍见证啊，他说就是一模一样，海水一波来了又退去，一波又来了又退去，很有节奏的，很有次序的。
The neighbors testified that it was likened to the sounds of the waves coming wave after wave and tied in and tied out. It was very rhythmic.
我们在用圣灵祷告，圣灵在帮助我们祷，帮助这些学生祷告。
We were praying in the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit was praying for the students.
发出的海浪的声音啊。
It produced the sounds of the waves.
这是外邦人很多个外邦人的见证的。
This was testified by many of these Gentiles. They heard it.
所以他们才跑到教会来看来听啊。
Which is why they found it strange to come to the church to hear it.
那就像主耶稣这里说的，好像众水的声音，这不过是其中一种水的声音。
Just as spoken by the Lord Jesus here, that it was likened to the sounds of the waters.
那一次祷告后，圣灵大大充满了，也让十几二十个学生得到圣灵。
During that prayer, the Holy Spirit was infilled among the members, and many of the students, more than 10 students, received the Holy Spirit.
我要讲第二个水的声音，圣灵好像重水的声音。
Now I'd like to share with you the second testimony about the Holy Spirit sounding like the sound of the waters.
有位信徒他病重已经在医院了有一段时间了。
There was a believer who was severely sick and ill and hospitalized for some time.
就叫家人做好准备了。
So the doctors told the family members to prepare themselves for the worst.
那么有些弟兄姐妹 这个时候也很也常去看他，去医院探访。
There were some brothers and sisters of the church who visited him quite often during this period.
那只是晚上九点多，已经过了探病的时间。
And at this visit, it was already past 9 p.m. and it was past their visiting hours.
这个信徒要去探访呢，他就忘记拿电话，也忘记了第几楼第几号，不知道在哪一层哪一楼哪一个房间都忘记了。
This believer who happened to be visiting this sick member, he forgot his number and he forgot which room and which floor that this member was.
那么他的车停在停车场的时候呢，他就听到唱诗的声音啊，有一群人在唱赞美诗。
But as he parked his car in the parking lot and he heard the sounds of a group of people singing hymns.
他就哦，那个声音是从哦四楼那边传下来的。
And this.
那边传下来的
voices of singing hymns seem to come from the fourth floor of the hospital.
那么他就从停车场一直往这个四楼啊跑去走去。
Therefore, he proceeded from the car park to the fourth floor.
那么正在上楼梯，听到瀑布的声音啊，有很大的瀑布的响声啊。
But as he walked up the stairs, he heard the sounds of the loud sounds of the waterfall.
心里都很激动啊，很火热。
He was very motivated.
医院怎么会有瀑布呢？怎么可能会有瀑布呢
？How could there be waterfall in the hospital？
然后他就跟着这个声音呢、啊，去找到那个房间。
He followed this sound of the waterfall and to find a room.
他推开门的时候，那个声音突然间变成小溪的声音，溪流的声音，声音比较柔和。
As soon as he pushed open the door of the ward, the sound of the waterfall immediately subsided into a very soft and gentle sound of a stream.
溪流的声音比较小，但是非常清楚的，非常清楚的。
Although the sound of the stream was a little gentler and softer, but it was very clear.
这时他推门进去，那个病房，那个我们的病者，那个病人正在祷告，躺在床上，双手放在胸前，正在祷告。
At this moment, when he entered the ward, and he saw that this sick member was actually lying on his bed, praying with his hands clasped in front of his chest.
他不敢惊到叫醒他，他自己也跟他一起在旁边祷告，在他的身旁祷告。
He did not want to disturb him, and therefore he stood by the side and also prayed together.
直到结束的时候呢，他说：“天使啊，天使，一直在讲天使啊，好多天使啊。”
At the end of the prayer, and he kept exclaiming, "There are angels, angels, so many angels."
他说天使唱诗给他听。
He said that the angels were singing hymns to him.
然后天使跟他一起祷告。
And also praying with him.
所以他不是在停车场那边就听到有一群人在唱诗吗？
Which is why the member at the car park actually heard sounds of singing hymns.
有瀑布的声音，又有小溪流的声音吗？那是天使在祷告呀。
There was also sounds of the waterfall and also sounds of the river stream. That was also the prayer of the angels.
这些都是很符合这个启示录十四章第一节、第二节里面所说的祷告的声音来的，众水的声音来的。
All these are well in accord with the description in the book of Revelation chapter 14 that it was the sounds of many waters.
那么圣灵的声音呢？这里说又好像大雷的声音哦。
He also describes that the Holy Spirit sounds like the loud sound of the thunder.
你听过打雷吗？
Have you heard of a loud thunder?
当然都听过打雷，那是响的时候你会有点害怕的。
You may be frightened at the sound of the thunder.
特别如果我们做了什么亏心事，做了什么对不起人的事，我们听到这个打雷的时候，你会更加害怕。
Most especially if you are guilty or you feel like you have done something wrong, then you will be frightened at the sound of thunder.
在我们的祷告当中的见证，圣灵责备的时候呢，真的好像大雷的声音啊，这样大声的。
In the testimonies of prayer, when the Holy Spirit is to rebuke and reprimand, and that sound was likened to the sound of the thunder.
大雷的声音也是神的声音，是圣灵的声音，也是神的声音。
This loud thunder and also is also the sound of the Holy Spirit and the voice of God.
神也在责备我们，圣灵在责备我们。
That God is rebuking us and the Holy Spirit is reprimanding us.
我们看诗篇二十九篇。
Return to Psalms chapter 29.
诗篇二十九篇。
Psalms chapter 29.
们读三节到四节啊。
Verse 3 to verse 4.
来，四节，三节。
Verse 3.
三，耶和华的声音发在水上，有没有？大水的声音。荣耀的神打雷了，耶和华打雷在大水之上，在我们祷告的时候。那第四节。
Verse 4.
耶和华的声音大有能力，耶和华的声音满有威严。第五节。
Verse 5.
耶和华的声音震破香柏树，耶和华震碎利巴伦的香柏树。这里都一直在描述，在见证神的声音，耶和华的声音。
This is a description and also testimony of the words of the Lord God.
这里说荣耀神的声音啊，好像打雷打在大水之上，好像打雷打在大水之上。
And it is described the God of glory thunders and over many waters.
有时我们用讲的，用劝勉的，我们不听啊，有时会惹神的愤怒，神就用打雷的声音来责备我们。
Sometimes we become
生气，一种生气的那种语气在责备我们。
We become so stubborn sometimes that we do not want to listen to a gentle advice, so much so that the wrath of God is provoked and the Lord God will speak to you in thunders.
应该是说愤怒啊，不只是生气，而是愤怒。
This is not just anger, but the wrath of God.
你们没有听过神愤怒的声音，你们不能够理解。
You will not be able to understand how the wrath of God looks like if you have never heard before.
爱我啊，神也疼我啊。
But the Lord God loves me.
我在30年的传道生涯中，两次被神责备，很大声的责备，很严厉、很严厉的责备。
In the 30 years of my life as a preacher, I have been reprimanded and scolded by the Lord God most severely 2 times.
真的，那时候的感觉，所听的就是打雷的声音，很大声，好像突然间打雷响起来。
The voice of the Lord God was the rebuke like unto the thunder, which was so loud and very serious.
神很生气的责备我说：“你这无知的人啊！我现在就要你的灵魂哦，是现在哦，不是今晚今夜要你灵魂，是现在就要你的灵魂。”
The Lord God rebuked me, saying that you foolish man, I am taking away your life right now.
哦，我真的是个无知的人啊。
And so I was a foolish man.
一个人听到这个打雷的声音啊，在发抖啊。一直在发抖。
I heard the sound of the thunder and I was trembling non-stop.
不单只手在发抖，身体发抖，那个脚也一直在发抖。我坐在车上，一直在发抖，在车上面一直在发抖。
I was seated in the car and my hands were trembling, my feet were shivering non-stop.
过后呢，安静下来了，就主耶稣就用很温柔的声音跟我说，很温柔的。
And after everything calmed down, the Lord Jesus spoke to me in a gentle voice.
人若赚得全世界
，If a man earns the whole world，
赔上自己的生命有什么益处呢
？Forfeits his life， what profit is there？
那是因为我要总会已经同意了，神却已经同意要去读神学院了，我不要去了，我自己逃跑了。这件事情很多人都不知道，连总会都不知道。
In fact, this is something that not many people know, and not even the GA knew about this, because I was assigned to for this theological seminary, but by the GA, but I was trying to run away.
被神用大雷的声音责备，这样的愤怒生气的声音责备，我才回去的。
After I was reprimanded by the sound of the thunder, that seriously, only then I returned.
那第二次就是在当传道的十多年以后。
The second rebuke was after about 10 years as a preacher.
神又用大雷的声音来责备我。
The Lord God rebuked me again with the sound of the thunder.
一响啊，整个人就没有力气啊，倒在地上啊，跌在地上啊，在传道房，在地上，我在传道房。
I was in the preacher's room, and at the sound of the thunder, I immediately collapsed on the floor.
很大声啊！所以说，你的心不正，圣灵责备我，你的心不正。
The sound of the Holy Spirit was very loud and reprimanding me that my heart was not upright.
你也不用想到太严重的事情了。
You don't have to think of it as a serious matter. I mean, a serious mistake that I made.
只是想要赚钱而已啊，所以说就不高兴了。
I only had the intention to try to earn some money, and the Lord Jesus was not happy with it.
那段时间就一直在想钱啊， 心不圣洁，心也没有专心在神啊，在传道的上面，传道的事工上面，一直想要赚。
During that period of time, my heart was not clean, and I was always thinking about how to earn more money, and my heart was not fully focused on the ministry of a preacher.
这样的责备还不够哦，那圣灵的力量带我起来，我已经没有力量起来了，圣灵啊给我力量啊，扶我起来，有种力量这样推我上来。
This rebuke was not even enough, and after I heard this, the Holy Spirit pulled me up.
那么他带我到哪里呢？圣灵扶我起来，带我到哪里？带我到桌子上啊，传道房的桌子上，带我到圣经那边去。桌子上放一本圣经。
The Holy Spirit
圣经
lifted me up and brought me to the table of the table in the preacher's room to the Bible.
那么一翻哦，一次而已哦，一翻就是《使徒行传》第八章。一翻就是《使徒行传》第八章。
The Holy Spirit guided me to flip the Bible only once, and I was able to see Acts of the Apostles chapter 8.
那圣灵就是好像很自动的，有一种力量哈、哦，把我的手哈、哦、伸出来，一指就是21节，第八章一指就是真正的指做21节。
And with a kind of a force, as guided by the Holy Spirit, my finger automatically pointed at chapter 8, verse 21.
看这一节哦，你在这道上无份无关。
If you read this verse, you have neither part nor portion in this matter.
为什么呢
？Why?
因为在神的面前，你的心无正。
For your heart is not right in the sight of God.
这是我亲身的经历啊。
This is my personal experience.
第一次是从天上来的声音嘛，好像打雷这样。
The first rebuke came from the heaven like a thunder.
第二次是圣灵借着圣经神的话，圣经的话来责备我。
The second time was through the words of the Bible, the Holy Spirit rebuked me.
圣经是没有声音的，圣灵也没有讲话，但是却好像被雷打到这样。我那种感觉又第二次被雷打到这样。
And although the Holy Spirit did not speak out, but allow me to read the Bible words, it felt like I was struck by lightning.
一样，然后开始一直在那边发抖啊，已经站坐了，站起来了，一直在站坐那边，一直发抖。
In the same manner, I was standing and trembling non-stop.
然后重点就是，因为我看到哦，在这神的道上，我已经跟神没有关系，跟主耶稣没有关系，无份无关，我已经没有关系了。
Because the main important point that I read here is that I would have neither part nor portion in the matter of salvation.
这个是让我最可怕的地方。
This is something that frightens me most.
当时的感受、哦、就是一片都黑暗了。
I felt like
都在黑暗里面。
I was cast into the darkness immediately.
当神离开我们的时候，或者我们离开神的时候，我们的生命啊，我们的生命都是黑暗的，没有光的。
If God
离开神啊
，If God departs from you or you depart from God, your life will be without light, and there will be no God with you.
越来越远，很遥远，很遥远，已经感受不到他的存在，完全感受不到了。
I felt like God was drifting away further and further away from me until the point I could not feel him anymore.
让你整个人进入到一种黑暗的阴间或者地狱里面，很可怕，很可怕的，很可怕的。
A feeling where your whole being has fallen into the pit of darkness, the abyss of hell, which is completely frightening.
我想今天的人啊，所做的恶事哦，比我刚被主耶稣责备的更严重，严重百倍啊！
That the wicked things that the people of the world have done must have been more serious than what I've done.
这样哦，只是想赚钱不专心呐、啊，不专一啦、啊，也可以说不忠心呐、啊，神就发怒了。
那 even at the small matter of me trying to thinking of earning money, and the Lord Jesus already regarded this as disloyalty.
今天多少人做的事情比这个更严重呀
？So how many people have done worse things today？
他们都没事啊，主耶稣也没有责备他们，也没有骂他们啊。
But the Lord Jesus did not reprimand them or rebuke them at all。
这是更可怕呀！主耶稣连骂都不用骂了，更可怕、啊。
And yet this should be even more frightening because the Lord Jesus didn't even bother to scold you。
所以我感谢神啊！如果我们在信仰上被神责备，我们要感谢神。你听到道理在责备你，你要感谢神，你真的要感谢神。
Therefore, I thank the Lord God and I beseech all of you to thank the Lord God, praise the Lord God. If you feel like you have been scolded or reprimanded,
神爱你啊， 神要救你啊。
Because the Lord God wants to save you out of his love.
不然我们真的在神的道上无份无关啊，跟神已经没有关系了，那就死亡而已啊。
Before you will lose your part and portion in the word of God, and you will be entering into darkness on the path of death.
所以你看看今天我们所听道理的心态，每一个包括甚至人言，我们的心态是如何？自己想检讨一下吧。
You examine yourselves in terms of your attitude towards listening to the sermon, including for the ministers of the church.
我要讲的就是圣灵的责备，圣灵的声音哦，好像打雷的声音，圣灵在责备你。
I'm trying to emphasize that the rebuke of the Holy Spirit is likened to the thunder reprimanding you.
我们继续来见证。
We continue to testify.
圣灵的声音又好像弹琴的琴声，好像弹琴的声音。
That the sound of the Holy Spirit is also likened to the harpist playing his harp.
我们有一次在开诗歌布道会的时候。
At an occasion when we conducted a hymnal evangelical service,
很多外邦人来参加嘛。
Many Gentiles non-believers came to attend.
那我们比较重视这个布道会，就会堂就布置得很漂亮，就请插花的师傅布置插花的师傅来插了，外邦人呢来插花。
And because we emphasize on this event a lot, and we hired a florist to beautify the event space.
这个插花师傅呢？他是跟那些王公啊，在王公王亲贵族啊，有婚宴啊，有生日啦、啊，有什么什么什么节目，他在王公插花的这个师傅啊，一般人请不到他的啦，一般小小的他不来的，他不做这种生意了。
This Gentile florist which we hired was a professional, so much so that he was well known for doing florist decoration for the royal family of the country.
但是他跟我们教会一位信徒非常要好，所以他就答应来了，就来帮助我们了。
Simply because he was a friend of our church member and he agreed to help us to beautify the event space.
都不收钱呐，不算钱。
And without any cost.
只算一些本钱，花的本钱啊，工钱不算。
Except some basic cost of the flowers of the raw material.
他正在准备插花，这些剪啊、修剪在排，我们就在教会祷告，他就在那边做他的事。我们就在教会祷告，他就在做他的事情。
As he was working and trimming the flowers, we were having a prayer.
他听到我们祷告的声音了，非常好听啊。
He heard that the sound of our prayer was very melodious.
祷告过后，他说：“喂，你们祷告很好听了，我很喜欢听呢。”
And after the prayer, he told us that I really enjoyed listening to your prayer. I loved it.
我很少听到这样外邦人的见证，通常都说我们祷告啊很吵啊，祷告很害怕，通常就是听到这样的回应。
This is such a rare testimony by a Gentile because usually Gentile people will hear the voices of our prayer as frightening and scary.
那我就问他：“那你听到很好听是什么声音呢？怎么样好听呢？”
And I asked him, how do you find the sound of our prayer as melodious or pleasant?
好像有人在弹琴的声音啊，而且这个琴非常好听哦。
And he was
琴的声音啊。
He testified that the sound of our prayer was likened to someone playing a musical instrument, playing a harp.
那我们在生活上有很多弹琴的人啊，我说是不是那种？他说这些差太远了，没得比啊。没得比、啊、这个世上弹琴的那种没得比啦、啊、还有形容不出来，非常美妙，非常的奇妙。
I was asking him whether it was likened to those musicians playing the musical instruments, but he said, no, this is far from that, it's far better, and it was miraculous and amazing.
你一祷告这个琴声就开始，当我们结束琴声就停止。
When you started your prayer, the sound of the musical instrument started playing, and until the end of your prayer,
所以过了几年，我们又请他来帮忙这个插花布道，这是在外面的，在外邦人的地方，那个礼堂啊，外面租礼堂来开诗歌布道会。过了几年
，few years later, we again hired him for a event that was conducted outside the church, which was in a public hall.
那么就是继续的，我们也会在现场那边祷告嘛，哈，诗班跟诗班一起祷告，他也在那边插花。
And the same manner, the choir and also me were praying while he was trimming the flowers.
他就心想哦， 这次我们祷告有没有琴声啊？就一直他就想这件事情。
And he was thinking to himself whether that would be the sound of the musical instrument or the harp during our prayer.
感谢神，经过几年过后，祷告的时候那个琴声又来了。他几年前听过那种弹琴的声音又出现了。
And again, we thank the Lord God that the sound of the harp playing like a musical instrument again came in as we started prayer.
他心里非常的高兴啊。
He was filled with joy in his heart.
哦，你们真耶稣教会真的是很特别的教会。
And he said that the True Jesus Church is indeed a very significant one.
你们的祷告我非常喜欢听，你们的祷告非常好听，我非常喜欢听。
I really love the sound of your prayer.
为什么呢？
Why?
因为他听到了启示录十四章二节说。好像弹琴所弹的声音，他听到弹琴的声音了。
Because what he heard was as described by a Revelation chapter 14 verse 2, the sound of the harpist playing his harp.
你请注意，这些都是外邦人在见证的呢。
But you take note that all these are testified by Gentile people.
更奇妙就是，经过了两三年过后，他还神还让他听到这样，没有改变了，就是一样，还是没有改变。
What was even more miraculous was that after a few years, and the Lord God still allowed him to hear the same thing during our prayer.
谁跟你讲圣灵的声音很难听？谁跟你讲圣灵的声音让人家害怕？
Now, who told you that the sound of the Holy Spirit was frightening and unpleasant?
如果有害怕，
if you find it frightening,
那绝对不是那种听到鬼的声音那种害怕，绝对不是。
It shouldn't be the kind of fright that you feel, been looking at a demon.
我们教会有一位信徒，她的丈夫是外邦人。
There was a member whose husband was a Gentile, a non-believer.
我们到她的家里去做家庭聚会，她要跑不掉了，因为我们已经到了，她也不好意思跑了。
We went to his house to have a family altar, and he could not escape this because we already arrived.
一般上呢。没有信主的呢，我们到他都会离开啦，他都会去找去外面啦，去找朋友啦，或者躲在房间啦，一般上都会这样啦。
But generally, if we make family visitation like this to someone's house, where the non-believing family members will escape and will have other appointments elsewhere,
我们就很客气的请他跟我们一起聚会了，说难得嘛，因为很少遇到你在家里，难得一跟我们一起，那他也很高兴在一起聚会祷告。
We cordially and sincerely invited him for the family prayer because it was such a rare opportunity and he obliged.
本来他跟我们一起祷告的。
Initially, he was praying with us.
刚刚开始不久啊，一两分钟啊，他没有办法祷告，他跑到厕所那边，躲在厕所不敢出来啊。
But not after one or two minutes of the prayer, he immediately stopped and he ran to the toilet and didn't want to come out.
后来他跟他的太太讲啊，做见证啊。
And later, he testified to his wife.
他听到我们祷告，他怕呀。
He heard our prayer, and he was scared.
那个怕不是怕鬼怕，那个不是啊。他就说，好像一个做错事、有罪的人哦，已经犯罪的人哦，看到法官了，看到警察了，觉得自己哦，满身罪哦，不敢啊，不敢听到这种神的声音啊，不敢啊，听到好像圣洁的声音，他不敢听到啊。
He was not scared from the fear of meeting a ghost or a demon, but he was scared because it was likened to bringing him to the court and face a judge in holiness, and he didn't.
那个神很有权柄，很有力量，而且拜作好像责备这样，他又听不懂啊，听不懂，但是他感受到就是这样，很有权柄，很威严，又带着好像责备在里面。
And this kind of a sound of prayer that he was very frightened about was the sound of authority and a sound of power that was rebuking him.
那是神的威严啊。
That is the authority of the Lord God.
只有做错事的人，只有有罪的人才怕警察，才怕上法庭，对不对？意思是这样。
Only thieves and robbers will be scared of the police, and this is what it means.
如果你有怕，那是怕圣灵的威严、神的权柄，不是你的怕，不是那种像那个邪灵的声音、那鬼的，不是那种怕，这个是敬畏神的怕。
This kind of fear is a godly fear, facing the holiness and the righteousness of God and the Holy Spirit, but not the fear of the devil.
这是他很深的体验。我们祷告的 祷告的声音，他很深的体验，有权柄啊，有威严啊。
This is his deep experience of the Holy Spirit, where it was full of authority and power.
有罪的人听了都会怕，知道自己做错事了，知道自己得罪神了。
People who have sins will recognize their own sin, and they will be fearful of God.
所以这种怕不跟那种怕不一样，是吧？不一样。
This kind of fear is different from the other kind of fear.
我讲最后一个声音，最后一个见证。
Allow me to testify a final testimony.
我们圣灵祷告的声音哦，好像军队哦，好像军队骑马出战的声音啊，军队骑着战马出去打仗的声音。
The sound of the prayer of the Holy Spirit sounded like an army riding on the horses marching into war.
那时是我们马来西亚七十周年，真耶稣教会七十周年的灵恩布道大会，是个很特别的盛会。
And it happened on the 70th anniversary spiritual convocation of the True Jesus Church. It was a very special event.
那也很多慕道朋友、亲戚朋友来参加。
And at this evangelical service, many non-believers came to attend.
那些慕道朋友都跟我们一起三天哦，三天都在教会里面。
And our friends and relatives who were Gentiles spent 3 days at the church.
在第二天祷告求圣灵的时候
，On the second day of prayer for the Holy Spirit.
嗯，我们这次七十周年的这个主题是启示录第六章一到二节的主题。启示录第六章一到二节的主题。
And the theme of this 70th anniversary convocation was the Revelation chapter 2.
那个第一个印哦，启示录第一个印就是元帅，我们的主耶稣，我们的元帅骑白马出战的意象。主耶稣坐白马出战。
And this was the seal where the Lord Jesus was riding on a white horse to marching into war.
所以我们的主题叫做白马出现。
And the theme was entitled the Lord Jesus emergence of the Lord Jesus on a white horse.
那么这个白马是主耶稣骑坐的，主耶稣在带领。骑在白马上面，带着教会出战。
And this white horse was being ridden by the Lord Jesus together with the church marching into war.
胜了又要胜。
That we will win victories after victories.
那么在祷告的时候呢，这个慕道者就听到一开始祷告就听到很多的马叫、马蹄声啊，马在嘶叫的声音嘛、啊，马叫的声音啊。
During the prayer, the non-believing members or the friends and relatives heard the sounds of the horses and also galloping of the horses in like to the war.
又听到战鼓啊，有打鼓的声音啊，好像古代打仗的时候有战鼓嘛。
They also heard sounds of the drums are rolling like to a war in the old times.
跟着呢，就一群很多的马，就是群马在奔跑、奔跑的声音啊，马在跑的声音。
And then he heard the sounds and the galloping noises of the horses running on the field.
我们问他，那么很多马在跑，那是很乱啊，很困的。他说不会，很有秩序的，那个声音非常有秩序的。
And we asked them,
虽然他在跑，但是很有秩序的。
We asked them, was it a very chaotic scene, or was it a very messy, noisy scene? But they described it as it was orderly, it was rhythmic, it was not messy.
他不知道这个是什么意思啊。
But they did not understand what that means.
就跟他讲，我们这次的主题就是启示录六章的第一印嘛，主耶稣骑着白马出战。
Because the theme, we told them the theme of this spiritual convocation was the Revelation chapter 6, the first seal where the Lord Jesus was riding on the white horse into the war.
这是很奇妙的一些声音啊，一些见证啊。
It was a very miraculous testimony of the sound of the Spirit.
因为我们的信仰就是个属灵的战争，我们祷告也是一种属灵的战争。
Because our faith is also a spiritual warfare, and our prayer is also a spiritual battle.
无论是为教会的圣工祷告，还是赶鬼祷告，都是一场战争。
Whether you are interceding in your prayer for other people, or whether you are trying to cast out demons in your prayer, this is a warfare.
感谢神啊！
Oh, thank God.
哦，这些都是圣灵的声音啊，各种各样的声音。但是众多声音当中，都是很好听的，很威严的。
These are all various kinds of the sounds of the Holy Spirit, and among all these sounds and voices of the Holy Spirit, they are melodious and they are full of power and authority.
啊，那时间到了，哦，还有很多这个圣灵的声音的见证，我们以后再讲。
My time is up, and I have a lot more testimonies to share with you the next time.
啊，我们来唱诗247首。
We sing him 247.
哦，唱诗247首，圣灵全能。
247, the Pentecostal power.
嗯，来，一二三，无损皆是在一路上显出非常全能，门徒句句同心祷告，直待圣灵降临。突然声响如风吹过，蛇心火焰降到头上，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在，全能如同现在，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在。圣灵降在个人身上，大家都说方言，存心就是传扬福音，敞开天国恩门，众人热衷如火焚烧，同心施主报答洪恩，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在，全能如同现在，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在。门徒都被圣灵充满，大得口才力量，到处见证救主耶稣，神迹奇事宣扬，胆小退缩变为刚强，一同出奇拯救亡羊，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在，全能如同现在，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在。虔诚求主赐下圣灵，老少均得领受，如无损皆充满个人，能力智慧极限，真理圣灵永不改变，恩赐全能古今皆然，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在，全能如同现在，全能全能，无损皆大全能，全能如同现在。 圣灵的全能，
The power of the Holy Spirit，
这是我们教会的见证。
Is the testimony of our church.
我们信仰的体验。
Is the experience of our faith.
一切荣耀归主耶稣。
All glory be unto the name of Jesus.
在这个毁谤的危机当中。
In a crisis of blasphemy.
我们分清楚，哦，圣灵为什么会被毁谤。
we are able to discern properly why the Holy Spirit was blasphemed.
也从启主耶稣在启示的启示当中，我们知道圣灵的声音是威严的，是好听的。
As we find out from the revelation of the Lord Jesus in the book of Revelation, the sound of the Holy Spirit is melodious, is full of power.
我们一起来祷告。
We pray together.
替为我们教会祈祷。
We also pray for the church.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利 Arrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr 아멘. 全能, 全能, 无所皆大, 全能, 全能如同现在, 全能如同现在, 全能, 全能, 无所皆大, 全能, 全能如同现在, 全能, 全能, 无所皆大全能, 全能如同现在, 全能如同现在, 全能, 全能, 无所皆大全能, 全能如同现在. 感谢主, 아멘. 感谢主耶稣祝福带领我们一整天的机会。
We thank the Lord Jesus for blessing and guiding us in the full day services that we have.
我们从早上聚会、中午聚会到傍晚的聚会。
We attended a morning service and an afternoon service and an evening service now.
我们看到信徒也一整天在聚会敬拜真神。
And we also can observe that our members have been serving the Lord God and worshiping the Lord God the full day.
这是荣耀神的事，也是合乎神旨意的事。
This is very glorifying to God and is also in accordance to His will.
哈利路亚, 阿们。
哈利路亚, 阿们。
好，聚会到这里结束，大家平安再见。
Service concludes here. May peace be with you.
那我们星期二继续第二章的危机。
On Tuesday evening, we'll continue the crisis in chapter 2.
还有什么危机呢？
What other crises are there?
好，我们星期二见。
Let's meet on Tuesday.